Libations, which is our show about mixology and making fine craft cocktails, hopefully. And we've done shows in the past that have dealt with scotch, because we find that many people cannot go past Rob Roy's and Rusty Nails in terms of cocktails made from scotch. And yet there are so many that you can make from scotch that are more innovative and creative and interesting. And one that we've made in the past, but this time we're going to tweak it a bit, is the Blood and Sand cocktail, which is based on scotch. And it's interesting to note that this cocktail was basically made after a Rudolph Valentino movie called Blood and Sand. And the movie came out in the 1920s, but this cocktail wasn't created until the 1990s. And it was created in New York City by a mixologist named Dale DeGroff. And it's quite an interesting cocktail. It's quite creative, in fact. And we're going to do something that I never normally do, too, is normally I use fresh orange in my drinks, but we're going to use actual orange juice because it lends the proper color to the cocktail. And again, this is called Blood and Sand after a Rudolph Valentino movie. And it's got scotch in it, cherry herring liqueur, sweet vermouth, and a couple of other ingredients, and it's quite good, if I say so myself. And I think, first of all, I'm going to put some ice in the shaker. And this is a drink that you drink after being made up in a shaker. And you could use a martini glass to dispense it in, but we're going to actually use a double old-fashioned glass with a cat logo on it, because I love cats. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and start with the scotch. And as you know, I free pour, so if you want measured estimates, you're not necessarily going to get them. And then we're going to put in the cherry herring at about half the ratio of the scotch. And I do recommend that you use cherry herring rather than a substitute, because cherry herring is a complicated liqueur. It's made of many different things other than just cherry, and there's herbs in it and all kinds of stuff, so you want to make sure that you don't miss out on that. And then we use sweet vermouth, and you could use any brand, doesn't have to be absolutely upscale. So we're going to add that, and then we're going to add the orange juice. And again, I recommend trying cocktails based on scotch, because if you don't venture that way, you're really missing out, and you're limiting yourself in your palate and your enjoyment of cocktails. And then we're going to attempt to shake this. And this shaker is sometimes a bit recalcitrant when it comes to dispensing the cocktail, but we'll see how it goes. And again, this is the Blood and Sand, named after a Rudolph Valentino movie. Yeah. And I'm spilling it all over the place, which is no surprise. And again, this will make you realize that everybody makes mistakes and boo-boos. You don't have to be perfect in everything that you do when you make cocktails. And I would say that this needs to be a little bit more bloody, so to speak, so I'm going to add a bit more cherry herring to it, and I'm going to taste it to make sure, this is quality control, of course, that it's what it's supposed to be. Oh yes, if I say so, that is really a nice cocktail. And many people think, boy, that's an incongruous combination, to have sweet vermouth, cherry herring, and scotch in a cocktail, and orange juice, but it really works well. And most people, when they heard about this, thought, you got to be kidding. But give it a try. Don't limit yourself and don't assume, you know, that it's not going to be good. Try it. And you could, like I said, use a martini glass to dispense this in, or you could use an old-fashioned glass or a double old-fashioned glass. And again, savor the flavor, because it really is unique. And I always mention this, but you don't have to buy top shelf scotch. You can buy a decent brand of scotch. You don't want to buy cheap rot gut, but you don't want to use a single malt either. That is for sipping and savoring. or even an upscale scotch, buy a modest one. And the same thing with the vermouth, but don't try to substitute anything for cherry herring. It's a one-of-a-kind thing. And the cocktail will not be the same. So again, scotch, sweet vermouth, cherry herring, orange juice instead of fresh squeezed orange juice, just regular orange juice. And you'll find that this is really an interesting cocktail, a unique one. You can just imagine Rudolph Valentino playing that bullfighter when you drink this cocktail. And I always mention this whenever I do my programs. We want to make sure that we drink responsibly. Keep our community safe and well spoken of. Don't find yourself behind the wheel if you're intoxicated. Either get some sort of a service like Uber or Lyft or a friend to take you around who has not had anything to drink. You don't want to endanger people. You don't want to harm yourself. So drink in moderation and be very careful if you're at a party. And I thank you again for tuning into another episode of Good Libations. I'm Ethel Andrews. I'm a mixologist. And try drinks based on scotch. You'll be surprised. Thank you.